Howdy, it's Tubal Cain again, and this is number 18A of the What Is It Mystery Tool series, and this is the question part. And thanks for all the funny answers that I'm getting, and I don't respond to all of them, but I appreciate them. Keep them clean, though, would you? And I got several different things to show you. Tell your friends about this series. The hits here, the numbers watching are really down on this series, so I'm having my doubts about it, but there seem to be some of you that are interested in this, but continue it for now anyway. But I got three different items. So, and be sure and look at my 350 other machine shop videos. This isn't really what you'd call a machine shop video. But these two tools were sent to me by Guy Lopez in Elk Grove, California, so they came a long way. And there is absolutely no name or number or anything on this. I myself do not know what it is. I will not be able to give you an answer unless someone comes up with an answer. Possibly it's just a portion of some other tool or device. So I'm not sure. Nicely made, blackened. This is half-inch square, so that might be for a half-inch socket or a ratchet, rather. This is about a 5/8 hole here, and it's off-center, knurled, and a cross hole. So, what is that? I don't know. He sent this too, and I don't think it's related to it. He had it in the same bag, but I don't think it's related. This is a 3/8 square hole, and it's made by the Bonnie Company, which was a big tool company years ago. I don't think they've been around for a while. And there's a number on there, too. I believe this is some type of specialty tool for a mechanic, but I don't know. So, anyone at all? Anyone? This brass tool came in an auction box just recently. Actually, it's a very common tool. I've had many, many of these, but usually they're made out of iron. This is a file that is held into this tool by a couple of brass screws. One's missing. I took the manufacturer's name and taped that up. Got a slot here, and I do know what it is, and I think that I'll get hundreds of people that know what this is. No longer used, but you see a lot of them around. This has very little value as a collectible tool, very little. So, what is this? This item came just today in a tube from Roger Taylor in San Marcos, California. That came a long way too. Thanks for sending that along, Roger. And thank you to Mr. Lopez a minute ago. I didn't give him a thank you, but thank you very much for you people that send this stuff on. And it cost $6.50 for Roger to send this, $6.65 to send it from California. But I don't know what it is. I do believe it to be a reamer of some sort. There is a name on here. I can't even read it properly because this obviously was held in a chuck and it's scored, knurled here and here, and I believe adjustable. These appear to be cutting blades, and there are two of them, just two. And on the other side here, there is a bar with these little pins on it, as if to space it, but I don't know what they're for. But offhand, I would think that it was some kind of adjustable reamer, but looking at it from this way, it's tapered. You see how much is sticking out here at the bottom compared to the top. And the other side the same. So hopefully somebody can tell me what this is. I believe it to be a reamer, but there would have to be a special purpose for it. And unless someone is positive about this, it's another one that I won't be able to identify just from that name that we saw on there. So give me your best guesses, and if you're new to this series, this is number 18, A, remember, 18B will be the answer coming along in a couple of weeks. So it gives people a chance to do a little research and think about it, and maybe ask your friends, have them look at it, increase the viewership just a little bit. And because some of my earlier ones had a lot of views, 15,000 or so. And there's some really neat tools in the other ones as well. So go to my playlist and look at some of those others if you're in the mood. But this is Tubal Cain saying so long for now.